America, which we once thought to be one of the world's richest countries with one of the best economic systems in the world, is not what we think it is. And millions of Americans are currently living a lie. The national debt is not just rising to depths unlike any ever seen before, but has also increased more than 2 times its original sum in just 10 years. Isn't that bonkers? But the craziest thing about all these is that if things keep going the way they are, the national debt would reach a jaw-dropping sum of $66 trillion in the next 10 years, which would leave thousands of Americans homeless. While America is currently regarded as one of the richest countries in the world, it currently has a national debt of over $33 trillion and counting. But the federal government continues to overspend without caution. America's national debate has been fueling debates for years. And the question on everyone's lips is not if America would ever go bankrupt, but when it will finally go bankrupt. Fingers are being pointed at the different factions of the government. After all, for a country's debt to increase, the government has to spend more money than it's making. At the moment, the federal government revenue stands at almost $4.6 trillion, while the government owes a staggering $1.4 trillion, bringing the total cost of running the states into a mind-boggling sum of $6 trillion. But why should the average citizen concern themselves with figures and political jargon? After all, as long as Uncle Sam keeps paying, they need not worry. The answer lies in the tangible impacts of excessive debt on everyday lives. When the national debt surpasses 85% of GDP, as it currently stands at over 120%, it becomes a drag on economic growth. This isn't just another groundless theory, it's a harsh reality documented in research from institutions like the Bank of International Settlements. As the debt increases, the ability to boost economic growth reduces, paving the way for risky policy decisions, while average citizens face the consequences. At the heart of America's current problem lies the clash between the members of the Congress and the Federal Reserve. The Federal Reserve attempts to manage the inflation crisis by introducing tax policy, while paying off some of the interests gotten from debt. But unfortunately, the federal government continues to spend without concern. To put this in clearer terms, the federal government is not just spending the entire revenue it gets through exportation, foreign trade, and individual and corporate taxes, it's also lending money, and we're talking of a nerve-wracking sum of $1.4 trillion. Do you know how many billions there are in a trillion? But hey, it's not America's fault that its debt keeps piling up. After all, as long as the revenue increases in the following year, the financial state of the country should return to normal. But the major problem with this way of thinking is that the federal government fails to consider the fact that the average rate of interest on the annual debt, which amounts to 3% of the actual debt. So what's the reason behind the increase in the national debt of the United States? America has seen one of the highest number of immigrants in recent years, leading to an increase in the cost of medical care, transportation, feeding, and housing. And to make matters worse, new immigrants move into different towns, while their cities or states are left with the dilemma of balancing up their budget. But while the federal government can spend more than it generates, it fails to consider US cities and states, which has to borrow more money to meet up with its budget. As the country continues to dive deeper and deeper into debt, the average American dives deeper and deeper into debt. Did you know that the average US citizen owes a minimum of $100,000? And this price increases to $250,000 for taxpayers. Insane, right? How could the average human have so much debt piled out in front of them? It all started from our long history of lending money, or taking money without restraint. The student loans that have been introduced into America's schooling system have made it much easier than ever for people to develop the habit of lending money from an early age. The government should probably be more honest about these problems to reduce some major spending decisions, but instead, everything is being sugar-coated for the people, and millions of Americans continue to live like there's no tomorrow. While things continue to take a plunge, immigrants continue to flood the country as they believe that there are numerous job opportunities that might pave the way to a better future. If things continue to get as bad as they currently are, the face of America today might change from what we once predicted it would be. The national debt doesn't just pose a question that many are still unable to answer. It would also leave us with more open wounds than scars, especially after the economy becomes so bad that budget cuts are implemented. Just recently, award-winning author and billionaire Robert Kiyosaki held an interview on YouTube where he gave an insight on how America went from being one of the richest countries in the world to one of the poorest countries in the world. Former Dallas Fed President Richard Fisher made a sobering revelation that the United States government is lending too much money, and a substantial amount of this money would mature in the next 3 years. The urgent need to repay this debt will have profound implications, pushing the average rate of interest on the national debt above 5%. This increase in interest payments will place an unbearable strain on the federal budget, while preventing the government from addressing America's needs and obligations. But isn't it quite surprising how the federal government seems to be unaffected by the shocking increase in the national debt? After all, a debt as significant as this is bound to make anyone have sleepless nights. Fisher would later reveal that the government was depending too much on Federal Reserves in times of national emergencies such as this one. But this time around, the members of the parliament might just be taking things with too much levity as things continue to spiral out of control. A national debt of $33 trillion? If that isn't insane, then I don't know what is. Currently, the four major fields that are consuming the entire national revenue are the Medicare system, the Social Security system, the national defense, and lastly, the interest gathered on debt, or maybe those super excessive weapons worth over $23 billion that the United States sent to Ukraine. But perhaps the greatest contributor to the current economic crisis is the breakout of COVID-19, which led to the shutting down of many businesses and enterprises. A lot of businesses filed for bankruptcy during this period, while others laid off their employees or simply reduced their wages. But Uncle Sam came through as always, giving out some unemployment benefits such as federal funds to those who were unemployed during this period. The situation of the country's economy was being kept under wraps before, but now that things have finally spiraled out of control, the Congress seems to be taking more time to actively discuss these items. Adding fuel to the fire is the fact that a vast majority of the Congress members are arguing over how the money is spent, and which factions of the government are spending more money rather than asking if it should be spent. But one could hardly blame them. After all, they're only humans who are more concerned about their own interests. When allocating funds to different Congress members, the bar is raised in terms of spending without care for the country's current debt. In fact, most Congress members would continue to spend excessively until they are brought down from their positions. Despite the glaring warning signs, only few congressmen are willing to make the tough decisions necessary to avert disaster. America's future, at the present, is highly dependent on its citizens and their ability to minimize loans and the members of Congress who are entrusted with the nation's finances. Which brings about the question, will the United States continue to spiral down in debt like it has been foretold to? Or will the members of the Congress step in and make the right decisions while returning the nation to its former glory? Despite all these, the United States remains one of the most prosperous countries in the world, with an annual revenue of $4.6 trillion. Perhaps if the finances are managed properly, the cycle of overspending might be ended. That's all for today's video. Don't forget to check out our channel for more engaging content. Have a great day, and thank you all so much for watching this video.